Hi everyone, my name is Nick. Welcome to this episode of the Connect series. Today we're going to be talking about an interesting topic, why and when to use Wi-Fi with Linux systems. And today I have Vihang from our Wi-Fi product line here, an expert on Wi-Fi systems, particularly with Linux, who's going to discuss this. Thanks for joining us.
Hey Nick, thanks for having me.
Yeah, so I guess maybe first question I have in general is, why use Wi-Fi in Linux systems? What's the difference between you using Wi-Fi in a Linux versus an embedded system?
Yep. So in the IoT type of applications, Internet of Things, we mostly see devices that are either low power, that have microcontrollers running the entire application, or when there is a need for higher data processing. We also see some high-end microcontrollers or microprocessors being used. And of course, Wi-Fi is used to provide connectivity to all of them. So when these microprocessor type of systems are using Wi-Fi, they usually have a higher level operating system like Linux running on it. Now, Wi-Fi, as we know, it's a mature standard from Wi-Fi Alliance, but it's continuously evolving. And Linux, because it's an open source system, it makes things a lot easier to include all these changes across all the devices that are based on Linux. So it makes your software much more scalable and from a Wi-Fi solution perspective, because it has network stack and a lot of components of the software already part of the Linux operating system, you can easily get those updates in your product. So we see this kind of systems with microprocessors using Linux in a lot of IoT applications, whether it's a thermostat in your home automation system or a video doorbell, or if you have medical devices with larger displays. And we also see some use cases in consumer electronics where you have like a speaker system that can use high data processing. So a lot of different use cases, but as long as you're using a Linux operating system or an OS based on Linux, you can leverage all these advantages of having a more scalable software.
Yeah, okay, so makes sense. Yeah, where you have systems with displays or complicated graphics with Linux already in the system and you want to attach Wi-Fi, there's a good use case for that, and you have scalability with Linux being open source. Makes sense. So what exactly does TI offer on this front, both on the hardware side and the software side?
True. Yeah, so TI have our WiLink family of Wi-Fi transceivers. They're based on 802.11 A, B, G, and N standard. And there's also an option to have integrated Bluetooth technology in these devices. So we have these devices available as certified modules, and they also have additional capabilities where you can run a Wi-Fi mesh use case in parallel. We have a complete hardware and software solution at TI. And the software drivers, when it comes to Linux operating system for WiLink devices, it's already integrated in the mainline Linux. So there's several advantages, like I mentioned before, scalability, but also it makes it a lot easier for you to get the latest update when you have a new Wi-Fi feature being released. So we have a complete driver, Wi-Fi driver and Bluetooth solution. And the best thing, this solution is all based on open source community contributions, and it's free of charge. If you have a Wi-Fi need in your processor type of system where you're using Linux, you can easily integrate TI WiLink certified modules and use the open source software free of charge.
That's great. Yeah, and that does kind of bring me to the next question is, being open source, what are still some of the advantages of going with the TI drivers, and how do you keep everything up to date with the Linux kernel releases?
Absolutely. That's an excellent question. So like I mentioned, the software drivers for our WiLink devices, they're integrated in mainline Linux. So there's a lot of effort that that goes behind in making sure the build processes are seamless and the overall integration experience for our customers is seamless. So we're constantly maintaining the older releases and also adding newer features. Now, the TI software solution for these Wi-Fi drivers is actually based on our Sitara processor SDKs. So these are the SDKs for TI Sitara processors, which are ARM Cortex-A core. And it's easily integrated into it, so you can bring up the hardware easily with Sitara processors. And the same build processes you can apply to any other processor that's running Linux. So there is that aspect of scalability, while also having a full ecosystem if you want to evaluate the solution. And TI has been making Wi-Fi devices and providing reliable drivers and software for decades when it comes to Wi-Fi. So we have a proven and reliable Wi-Fi software solution that has been deployed in millions of devices in the market. That being said, we do perform internal testing and checks to ensure high degree of interoperability. For example, we have an interoperability lab in TI, which kind of which tests our every new software release with 200 plus commonly used access points on the market. So that helps you ensure that even though it's an open source software, you can use it and be highly confident that it will not have some interoperability problems with certain models of access point out there. Additionally, we also do pre-certification of our software solution, meaning we test it internally to make sure it meets all the requirements and the overall certification process is easy. And that also helps you with your time to market when you're developing a Linux-based system and using a WiLink solution with Wi-Fi drivers. So we have several advantages there. And like I mentioned, we keep it up to date. For example, just last month in October 2020, we had a new release of WiLink 8 Wi-Fi software drivers where we added new features and also some enhancements to make the solution more stable.
Okay, got it. Yeah, makes sense. And what are some of the new features that are in the latest release from TI?
Yeah, so one of the main features in the latest release is the support for WPA3 security standard. So it is the latest standard in Wi-Fi security, and TI solution, they support both WPA3 personal and enterprise at both the device driver in Linux and also the device firmware level that is running on the device. And this is an upcoming requirement, actually. If you want to certify your device with Wi-Fi Alliance now, this is a mandatory requirement to have this latest WPA3 security. So we do support that. And we also aligned this latest software release with a 4.19 kernel. What that helps you ensure is that if you're using a newer Linux kernel, you can be confident that it's tested and gone through the full testing cycle on the 4.19 kernel to make sure that you can easily port it to any other newer kernel. Or if you're using Sitara Processor SDK, you can align it with the latest SDK available out there. And besides this, we had several minor feature updates, like this release supports the latest Wi-Fi supplicant version in Linux kernel. And also, WiLink devices have mesh network capabilities. So this new software release also includes some optimizations for this mesh network. And overall, it includes a lot of stability-related enhancements that will help you make your solution more robust.
Okay, yeah, great. Thanks for going over the new features in that latest release. Now, if people want to get started with that release, get started with the hardware that you spoke about, where can they do that?
Yeah, so I'll have a link below for the latest software release page that can walk you through what are the new features and how to get started on the software side. It will also have a getting started user guide that can walk you through which WiLink module best fits your requirements and where to find EVMs, where you can order them, and also what are the different software options and different tools from development phase to testing and production line testing challenges. So we have a wide variety of software tools and also hardware EVMs that can help you with the entire design process.
All right, well, thank you, Vihang. Thank you very much for joining and talking through TI's Linux Wi-Fi offering and where to get started. And thank you, everyone, for tuning in to this episode of the Connect series. As always, there will be more great content coming up. Don't forget to check out the podcast as well. And you can get started at TI.com. And you can find any of this information that we're referencing. Thanks, everyone.